So one by one we'll discuss these three protractors. So firstly, vernier bevel protractor. So the vernier bevel protractor is a simplest angle measuring instrument, which consists of main body, base plate, stock, and adjustable blade, and circular plate containing the vernier scale. Acute angle attachment. This figure shows a vernier bevel protractor with acute angle attachment. The body of the V-shaped bevel protractor is designed in such a way that its back is very flat and there are no projections beyond its back. The flatness of the body is tested by checking the squareness of blade with respect to the base plate when the blade is set at 90 degrees. Here the base plate is attached to the main body and an adjustable blade is attached to the circular plate containing the vernier scale. The main scale graduated in degrees is provided on the main body. The adjustable blade is capable of rotating freely about the center of main scale engraved on the body of instrument, which can be locked in any position. An acute angle attachment is provided at the top as shown in this figure for measuring the acute angles. The base of the base plate is made very flat so that it could be laid flat upon the work and any type of angles measured. The blade can be moved along throughout its length and can also be reversed. It is about 150 or 300 meters long and 13 mm wide and 2 mm thickness. So its ends are beveled at angles of 45 and 60 degrees. The acute angle attachment can be readily fitted into the body and clamped in any position. The bevel protractor are tested for flatness, squareness, parallelism, straightness, etc. So here in this figure, the main scale is graduated in degrees of arc. The vernier scale has 12 divisions, each side of the center 0. There are marked 0 to 60 minutes of arc so that each division equals 1 by 12 of 60, that is 5 minutes of the arc. These 12 divisions occupy the same space as 23 degrees on the main scale. Therefore, each division of the vernier is equal to 1 by 12 of 23 degrees or 111 by 12 degrees. Since 2 divisions on the main scale equals 2 degrees of arc, the difference between 2 divisions on the main scale equals 2 degrees of arc. The difference between 2 divisions on the main scale and 1 division on the vernier scale is 2 degrees minus of 1 by 12 of 23, that equal to 1 by 12 degrees or 5 minutes of the arc. Okay, so now what is the uses of vernier bevel protractor? So there is use of bevel protractor for checking the inside beveled face of the ground surface, and it is used for checking the V blocks, and it is used for measuring the acute angles. Okay, so this is the vernier bevel protractor. And now coming to the next bevel protractor is universal bevel protractor. The universal bevel protractor is used for measuring and laying out of angles accurately and precisely within 5 minutes. The protractor dial is slotted to hold a blade, which can be rotated with a dial to the required angle, and it can also be adjusted independently at any desired length. The blade can be locked in any position. Okay, and now coming to the optical bevel protractor. So it is a recent development of vernier bevel protractor. By using this instrument, it is possible to take the readings up to approximately 2 minutes of an arc. And the interval circular scale is graduated in the divisions of 10 minutes of arc. So the readings are taken against the fixed index line or vernier by means of optical magnifying system, which is integral with the instrument. So the scale is graduated as a full circle marked 0 to 90, 0.90 to 0.90. The zero position corresponds to the condition when the table is parallel to the stock. The provision is also made for adjusting the focus of the system to accommodate normal variation in eyesight. The scale and vernier are so arranged that they are always in focus in the optical system. Okay, so I hope everyone understand this optical bevel protractor. So in the universal bevel protractor, this is how it looks like a universal bevel protractor. So you will have a blade. Okay, so here is a blade, will have a slot. So here, if you see, there is a slot where there is an end mill which is made. So it is at an angle 60 degrees, and here it is cut at some other angle, it is 45 degrees. So this called also used for placing the references. And in this the blade, you will see a fine adjustment knob also, which are protractor, and which slides through which can slide. So the protractor is a clamp to the protractor is clamped to the blade by the blade clamper, and this is in turn is clamping by this, such that you make sure that this line is in the parallel or it's coincide with the measuring object. So you will have a protractor which is at the bottom. So here is a magnifying lens, because in order to show the, in order to have a clarity in reading. So here you see a lens is attached to it, and you get the data. So here is a reference plane is also there. You can place the entire scale with respect to this reference plane. If you want, you can also place the object. It is again an equiangular attachment. So it is 90 degrees, and this at 30 degrees also we can adjust. So you can see these angles which are used to place the workpiece or dial with the workpiece and make it flat. Okay, so it is an angular measuring instrument which is capable of measuring angles to within 5 minutes. So the protractor dial is mounted on the circular cross section of the base. The protractor dial is graduated in degrees with every 10th degree numbered. So vernier, the slide blade is fitted into the dial. It may be extended to either directions set at an angle to the base. The blade and the dial are rotated as a unit. So the fine adjustments are obtained with a small knurled head pinion that is used, so that we can try to do fine adjustment and get the details. So these are the fine adjustment knobs which are there, so that we try to see the matching of this vernier and also the protractor angles. So the protractor dial may be locked, the spacing is vernier is made in such way that at least the least count corresponding to 1 by 12th of the degree. So 1 by 12th of the degree, okay. Suppose you take 60 or 360, you can get get off 1 by 12th of it, okay. So this is the universal bevel protractor. I hope everyone understand this universal bevel protractor and optical bevel protractor. So optical bevel protractor means optical bevel protractor is a simple extension of universal bevel protractor. Here we use a lens in the form of an eyepiece is provided to facilitate easy reading of projected scale. The blade is clamped to the dial by means of a blade clamper. So if you look at it, here is a working edge is also there. You can keep an acute angle, and this is base, there is a clamp, and here you have a small eyepieces to look at a reading. Here the blade is there which comes in contact with the workpiece, and then the blade clamping device what we use, it is almost very similar to that of bevel protractor except for the optical thing which is visible. So in a vernier protractor, the eyepiece is attached on the top view of vernier scale itself, which together moves and single unit over the stationary dial scale. So the eyepiece provides in a magnified manner. So the acute angle attached is provided to facilitate the acute angle on the workpiece. So if you want to measure, you can do it. Second thing is a clamp is provided to lock for the reading, okay. So there is a clamp which tries to try and then which prevents it from rotating. So you look at the eye and then try to make the reading. So you will have a vernier reading also here. So these are the various protractors in the metrology. I hope everyone understand this concept. Okay, so next thing is sine bar. Next concept is next instrument is sine bar. So device, so it is a sine bar is a precision angle measuring instrument which is used along with the slip gauges. So what we do is here is a slip gauge. So you put the slip gauges at one end of the roller, you put the slip gauge. So basically what you do is you keep on height. So and here what you do is it is a flat surface. So now you place it on an incline, and then you put the workpiece here, then the dial to find out what we say is the theta, to find the theta. So we have to find out the theta. So generally it's a precision instrument to measure the angles very accurately and to locate the workpiece to a given angle within a close limits. So generally it consists of a steel bar and two rollers. So the sine bar is made of high carbon, high chromium corrosion resistant steel, which is suitably hardened and precision ground and stabilized. The rollers are of accurate and equal diameters. They are attached to the bar at each end. The axis of these rollers are parallel to each other and also to the upper surface of the bar. The normal distance between the axis of rollers is exactly of about 100 mm, 200 mm or 300 mm. So when the rollers are brought in contact with the flat surface, the top of the bar is parallel to the surface. So the various parts are hardened and stabilized before grinding and lapping. So all the working surfaces of the bar and the cylindrical surfaces are fine to the surface of 0.2 micrometers, the roughness value or some better things. So sign bars are graded as A grade or B grade sign bar. So A grade, B grade sign bars with accuracy of 0.02 mm per meter of length. So there are, these are various types of applications. So several if you do, you will have D. Between two rollers the distance is L, so length of the rollers, that means length of the sign bar, distance between the rollers. So the of the angle multiplied between the face plate, which is the datum, is given rollers. So what we are, some object and right, and we have a roller. On the other way around we have this. So you have one more roller here, okay. This is resting on the slip gauge. There is a slip gauge of heights, height h by l, you have to find out. So the principle of operation of sign bar is based on loss of their combination of slip gauges is inserted under the second roller, okay. So then sin theta equal to h by l, that is equal to theta equal to sin. So for this reason the device is called sign bar, okay, to exist. So the axis of rollers must be parallel to, and next one is the top surface of bar must have a high degree of flat rollers, and the rollers must be of identical diameters and round within a closed tolerance. Bars, this applications of sine bar means you have to find out the theta, you have to measure the angles, okay. Next angular instrument is sine center. So due to difficulty of mounting conical work easily on the conventional sine bar, and sign centers are used. So here two blocks are shown in the figure are mounted on the top of sign bar. These blocks accommodate centers and can be clamped at any position on the sign bar. So the centers can also be adjusted depending on the length of the conical workpiece to be held between the centers. So sign centers are extremely useful for the testing of conical work, since the centers ensure correct alignment of the workpiece. The procedure for its setting is same as that of for sign bar. Okay. Now sign table. So the sign table is the most convenient and accurate design for heavy workpiece. So the equipment consists of self-contained sign bar hinged at one roller and mounted on its datum surface. So the table is quite rigid and weight of unit and workpiece is given fuller and safer support. The table may be safely swing to at any angle from 0 to 90 degrees by pivoting it about its hinged end. Due to the work held axially between the centers, the angle of inclination will be half the included angle of the work. The use of sign centers and sign tables provides a convenient method of measuring the angle of taper plug gauge. Okay, so our next instrument is angle gauges. So angle gauges was developed by Dr. Tomlinson in 1941, which enable any angle to be set at nearest 3 inches. So these are the pieces of hardened and stabilized steel. The measuring faces are lapped and polished to a high degree of accuracy and flatness. They are 75 mm long and 16 mm wide and are available in two sets. One set consists of 12 pieces and a square block in three series of values of angle. So like 1 degree, 3 degree, 9 degree, 27 degree and 41 and 1, 3, 9 and 27 and 6 inches, 6, 18 inches and 30 inches. And another set contains 13 pieces and a square block. So 1 degree, 3 degree, 9 degree, 27 degrees and 41 degrees and 1 inch to 3 minutes, 9 minutes, 27 minutes and 3 inches, 6, 18, 30. So each angle gauge is accurate to within 1 second and is marked with engraved V, which indicates the direction of the inclined angle. So these gauges together with a square block can be so rung that any angle between the 0 to 360 degrees can be set. So each angle gauge is a wedge. Thus two gauges with their narrow ends together provide an angle which is the sum of the angles of individual gauges. So the subtraction of angles is obtained when the narrow ends are opposed, as shown in this figure. So each angle gauge is marked with engraved V, which indicates the direction of included angle. When the angles of individual angle gauges are to be added up, then the V of all should be in line. And when any angle is to be subtracted, its engraved V should be in the other direction. Okay, so general uses of angle gauges are widely used in industries for quick measurement of angles in between the two surfaces. So a frequent use of these gauges is to check whether the component is within its tolerance angle or otherwise. So where the angle to be measured exceeds 90 degrees, the use of precision square becomes essential. So the main limitations of this instrument is by combining the angle gauges, any angle could be made, but the block formed by the combination of number of these gauges is rather bulky and cannot always be conveniently applied to the work. So they are used as reference along with other angle measuring devices. So secondly, errors are easily compounded when angle blocks are rung in combination. So this is the clear cut information about the sign center, sign tables and angle gauges. Okay, and the next instrument is a clinometer. So clinometer is a spirit level mounted on a rotary member. So the angle of inclination of a rotary member relative to its base can be measured by a circular scale. Okay, so there are the various types of clinometers. Vernier clinometer, it is shown in this figure. So it consists of a spirit level mounted on a rotary member carried in a housing. One face of the housing forms the base of the instrument and there is a circular scale on the housing. The angle of inclination of rotary member relative to the base can be measured by a circular scale. So the scale may cover the whole circle or only the part of it. The clinometers are generally used to determine the angle included between the two adjacent faces of a workpiece. So the base of the instrument is placed on one of the surfaces and rotary member is adjusted till zero reading of the bubble is obtained. So the angle of rotation is then noted on the circular scale against an index. The instrument is then placed on the other surface and the reading is taken in the similar manner. If theta and pi are the reading of instrument, the included angle between the surface is alpha equal to 180 minus of theta minus pi. So this is the okay. So next clinometer is a micrometer clinometer. So in this type, the spirit level is attached at one end of the barrel of micrometer. So the other end of the spirit level is hinged on the base. So the base is placed on the surface whose inclination is to be measured. So here the micrometer is adjusted till the level is horizontal. So this type of clinometer is used for measuring the small angles. And the next clinometer is dial clinometer. So the dial clinometer is similar in the principle to the bevel protractor. So the spirit level is attached to a gear and a dial gauge. So the whole angle can be observed through an opening in the dial on the circular scale on the gear, and the fraction of the angle can be read on the dial gauge. Okay, and next clinometer is optical clinometer. So it consists of a rotatable turret which is mounted on the base. The spirit level is provided on the turret, and the readings are taken by measuring microscope on a graduated scale provided on a fixed circular glass disc concentric with a turret. So with this instrument, angle even equal to 1 minute can be measured. So the vernier scale is provided in this microscope. So overall, the uses of clinometers are which are used for checking included angles, relief angles, as well as angular faces on large cutting tools and milling cutter inserts. So they can also be used for setting inclinable tables on jig boring machines and angular work on grinding machines, etc. So this is the information about the clinometers. And next instrument is autocollimator. Autocollimator. So autocollimator is an optical instrument used for the measurement of small angular differences or changes or deflection, plane surface inspections, etc. So the principle of working for this autocollimator. If a light source is placed in the focus of a collimating lens, it is projected as a parallel beam of light. If this beam is made to strike a plane reflector kept normal to the optical axis, it is reflected back along its own path and is brought to the same focus. If the reflector is tilted through a small angle theta, the parallel beam is deflected twice that angle and is brought to a focus in the same plane as the light source, but to one side at the distance x equal to 2f theta. So where f is a focal length of lens and theta is the angle of inclination of a reflecting mirror. Now the construction of this autocollimator. In an autocollimator there are three parts: micrometer, microscope, and lighting unit and collimating lens. A line diagram of a modern autocollimator is shown in this figure. So in this, a 45 degrees transparent beam splitter reflects the light from the graticule towards the objective. So that means collimating lenses. So the image seen after the reflection in the external reflector, whose angular variations are being measured, informed by the light from the objective lens. So this light passes through the beam splitter and the image is picked up by the microscope. For simultaneous measurements in two planes at right angles, a micrometer is fitted to the largest graticule optically at right angles to that on the eyepiece graticule. Okay, so this is the information about the autocollimator and various applications of autocollimator. So These autocollimators are used for the measurement of straightness and flatness of surfaces and precise angular indexing in conjunction with polygons and comparative measurement using master angles and assessment of squareness and parallelism of components, the measurement of small linear dimensions and for the machine tool adjustment setting, etc. So this autocollimator instrument is also in the unit 3 optical measuring instruments, and unit 2 also autocollimator is there. So next instrument is angle decker. So this is the type of autocollimator. It consists of a microscope, objective lens, that means collimating lens, and two scales engraved on glass screen, which is placed in the focal plane of objective lens. One of the scales, called datum scale, is horizontal and fixed, and it is engraved across the center of the screen and is always visible in the microscope eyepiece. And another scale is an illuminated vertical scale fixed across the center of the screen, and the reflected image of the illuminated scale is received at right angles to this fixed scale, and the two scales in the position intersect each other. So thus the reading on the illuminated scale measures angular deviations from one axis at 90 degrees to the optical axis, and the reading on the fixed datum scale measures the deviation about an axis mutually perpendicular to the other two. Okay, so thus the changes in the angular position of the reflector in two planes are indicated by the chances in the point of intersection of two scales. So readings from the scale are read direct to 1 minute without the use of a micrometer. The whole optical system is enclosed in the tube, which is mounted on the adjustable bracket. So the adjustable bracket is attached to the flat lapped reflective base as shown in this figure. So this is the information about the angle decker. Okay, I hope everyone understand the today's lecture topics like protractors, vernier bevel protractor, optical bevel protractor, sign bar, and sign bar with the slip gauges experiment, and sign center, and sign table, angle gauges, clinometers, and optical autocollimator, and auto decker, angle decker. Okay, so everyone read this, stay home, stay safe. Thank you. Bye.